Have you ever made a bad purchase? Have you ever bought something online, looked at it, and when it was delivered, chucked it to the bin? Have you ever bought something so useless that you started judging your past self? We run in a system where consumerism drives the economy. The more we spend on useless junk, the more useless junk gets produced. The more money this useless junk sector produces. Now, while it may be questionable as to why excessive consumption is socially acceptable, it also has detrimental impacts, starting from carbon footprint and ending with ethics. Degrowth is a radical political and economic theory that is basically the demure cousin of economic theories. It aims to reduce the excessiveness of consumption by abandoning GDP, or gross domestic product, as the goal of growth and progress. The mindset around growth is based around increasing production every year regardless of the need. While degrowth argues for scaling unnecessary production, focus economic activity around securing human needs and well-being, which enables rapid decarbonisation. Why is degrowth so radical and controversial? Well, they argue the shrinking of economies, not in the same way as a recession, but in a way that destabilises economies and achieves social and ecological goals. Here's a chart of what degrowth argues in a macro sense, for wealthier countries to shrink and meet the poor countries in the middle. Yeah, I can think of so many people who hate this. It might be difficult to wrap our head around what degrowth looks like, especially since I've only talked about the macro aspects of degrowth. Policies on degrowth can include reduce less necessary production by scaling down fossil fuels, mass-produce meat, dairy, fast fashion, cars, and aviation. Improve public services such as healthcare, education, housing, transportation, internet, renewable energy, and nutritious food. Improving the skill and availability of green jobs by training and mobilizing labor more towards urgent stuff like installing renewables, installing buildings, insulating buildings, regenerating ecosystems, and improving social care. Reducing working time is more than just a mental health scheme, but some say it lowers carbon emissions, frees people to engage in care and other welfare improving activities, stabilizing employment while less necessary production declines. And lastly, enable sustainable development. That's just a policy. On a micro level, practical degrowth actions can include buying less stuff, growing your own food, and using what you already have. So basically, circular economy. Now this is the part of the video where I list all the counter arguments and balance out the conversation, but I'm tired. I need to get this video up by today because I'm traveling tomorrow, and there's a redonkulous amount of counter arguments. So my challenge for all of you is to comment down below on the Discord your critique on degrowth. Why do you think degrowth is good? Why do you think degrowth is bad? Put your lawyer hat on and your opinions on degrowth. Do you think this is one of those brain rot Minecraft videos? Think again. We think outside the box in this channel. You're through.